Okay, fine. Today I'm going to tell you all about black holes. So first question is, what are black holes? According to research, there are millions and billions of black holes in our universe, and a black hole is actually a star which has collapsed due to its gravitational force. Now I'll tell you all how it forms. Now imagine our sun. Our sun's mass is equal to one solar mass. So there are many billions of stars heavier than the sun, and a black hole is actually a star with almost more than 100 solar masses, meaning 100 times the mass of the sun. So these stars have incredibly high amount of fuel, and as due to their high mass, they have a high gravitational force. So due to the gravitational force, there needs to be a force counterbalancing the gravitational force. So this force is the pressure exerted by the nuclear fusion, energy exerted by the nuclear fusion when the hydrogen atoms collide to form helium atoms, and this energy counterbalances the gravitational force. But once these hydrogen atoms and the fuels get over, there's no force to counterbalance the gravitational force. So due to this, the huge amount of gravitational force gets overpowered, and the star collapses into such a tiny small thing that's really densely compacted. So it becomes so small that it's almost the size of our Earth from billions, hundreds of solar masses. It becomes so small, and gravitational force is at its peak. So at this time, now whenever something passes near it, it said that it cannot escape. Now imagine my hand is a black hole. Even light can't escape when it's passing near it. So this is the ray of light passing near the black hole. So when it comes, the gravitational force influences this ray of light and pulls it towards it, forming a whirl. The light forms a whirl. But yeah, this is how it forms and how it works. Now I'm going to tell you all about event horizon. The event horizon is the boundary up to which the gravitational force acts upon. So if this is the black hole, this is the boundary to which the gravitational force acts upon. The ray of light travels outside, then it will go in a straight line. So now, after the event horizon, there's another point. Actually, we can't really see the black holes, because when light is passing through them, the light is pulled by the black hole and it never returns to our eyes to see the black hole. So the black hole cannot be observed so easily. But scientists observe the black holes due to the variation of the motion of the stars nearby. As it has a really strong gravitational force, it affects the motion of the stars in a really great manner.